Tick, tock, 12 o'clock. Time to go to bed. I thought I was over you, but I have to admit, it was great seeing you after so long. Maybe I was wrong about us. I don't know. It's a big decision. Come see me when you've made up your mind.
When I was 6, I was in a car accident and I almost lost my leg. I bit my tongue off and broke my jaw right down the middle, and I think that's made me who I am. People telling me you'll never walk again, or telling me this or that about yourself. Overcoming that through my early childhood probably shaped and molded me. I really don't like looking at video of me when I was a little girl, because I look at that really disturbed child, and it bothers me that I had to be so serious at 6 and 8 years old.
buddy! When'd you get back in town? How you been? Man, if you're here, we have to meet up. You know, spray the town red like the old days. I just have to figure out where the hell I am. The streets don't look the same anymore.
You better not be late. Not this time.
You're alive, dude. Enjoy what you want to. Tomorrow's not guaranteed. Today is a fucking realization. Yesterday is gone, like fucking 2,000, 5,000 years ago. Either you believe a truth or you believe a lie. Some may live and some may die. Predominant thought rules the cosmos. Laugh about it, it's a joke.
Closer to that consciousness than others. There's vibrations, there's thoughts, there's contact, and some people are just in tune with that. And when they allow it to happen, they can hear and see and help those spirits pass on, move on, continue on, or give them a message or take a message from them. That definitely could happen.
can only ask a question that only you can answer. That's the trick about questions. You contemplate things before those who told you what to contemplate thought. When you're born, you don't know. So you come into this place, but it doesn't replace like knowing or thinking about a seed being planted in the ground. We were seeds being planted to grow into sons. People need to hear that or they'll die.
Sorry, got disconnected there. So, why'd you come back? Wait a second. You're here to see Dana, you dog. What, you gonna get back together again? What was that? Is there someone there with you?
what happens when you die, like what happens to your mind, it's for eternity sort of thing. You don't remember everything that happened before you were born, you just sort of popped into life like that, so I think you kind of get sad if you think about it, but if you think about it, like, it's going to happen to everyone eventually. There's nothing you can do about it, it's inevitable. I don't think anyone really knows, I don't think we'll ever know until it happens. I like to think that maybe something happens and you die and do something, I don't know, or like the human race will go on to, I don't know.
Hey there, buddy. What? Dana was there? Just now? Then why are you on the phone talking to me? Get going. You're gonna miss your chance.
They see your light, they're jealous of it, and they may lash out at you. When I sense that, I try not to give some of the, like, over-the-top people, I don't even give them eye contact, and that usually works. They'll just keep walking. Yeah, just don't give them the eye contact, and they can't latch onto you.
time that I've been on the internet. Almost 44% of revenues.
Oh. Toy, like this little glowworm toy, and you know, I put it like on the lamp, you know, help to like light it up at night, and you know, it'll stay warm and it wouldn't make the room so dark. I didn't really like dark rooms, but it was more of like scary movies, which I knew was fake, but as a kid you still have this imagination and everything. I don't know where my little glowworm is. I guess he got lost.
Thank you.
Just, you know, walking down the street, it just shows how people are. I hate to use the word hate, but sometimes you just have to hate people for how they are, the way they are. It's not because it's the way their mother and their father raised them. It's just the way they choose to act. Even though their mother and their father treated them well, they choose to be mean and evil because they don't get things their way.
Evolving, and human beings are no exception. We're always evolving, and we're at a stage now that we need to grow out of. Right? Humanity is just on a crash course to, you know, oblivion, you know. But people, everybody I talk to, I mean, everybody seems to know that, but nobody seems to be able to do anything about it. I just kind of accept the fact that, you know, we're all going to die one day, and might as well make the most of it while we're here. Once you accept that that life and death are just two sides of the same darn thing, people don't have to live in fear anymore.
Why'd you break up with Dana anyway? You two seemed made for each other, you know? Like the perfect pair. Can't imagine her with anyone else. But, hey, I mean, you were so busy back then. Hard to make time. Believe me, I know.
Whether it's human life or not, you know, I think life is an eternal thing. It's just the same as creation. I mean, you can call it creation, whatever it is, it's happening, it's always happening. Something's happening, right? It's always gonna be happening. And if there's nobody here to experience, that's gonna be a shame. But I think consciousness is also eternal as well. So if it's whatever form it takes, it's always gonna be here. We got a chance to keep it going for a while anyway, you know, till the end of the universe anyway.
I think it's about enlightenment, and it's about the next consciousness. God does not let things go on too long before he says, wait a minute, let me smack y'all around a little bit to get y'all head straight. I think that where we end, another consciousness begins, that it might be the end for us in terms of our section. I don't think that God would just leave one section. I think that God continually progresses, and there's progression, and I think that what's next is our next progression.
Your things when you went away, you know. I ended up stacking it together. I made a little art project out of it. I don't know. I thought it might help me figure out what went wrong. I'll take my share of the blame. I can be hard to read, but I never gave up on you. And I guess that's what hurts the most. That you gave up on us.
Oh.
Inside of me that was steadily fighting, you know, the negative energies within me. I had this light that was still fighting, you know, trying to keep myself sane. Really, it was just all about, it was trying to make me be on a low level to where, like, I was just doing drugs and just being a sloth. I had to fight that and just still, you know, live.
Buddy, let me tell you a story. My neighbor would let his cat out every night, and it'd screech and yowl till God knows when. Whole neighborhood couldn't sleep. I warned my neighbor, but he kept letting it out. So, I took care of it. I mean, I didn't want to, buddy, but you know what? It had to be done.
Like, probably by the time my brother's, like, 30, it'll be way worse. nobody's really cares, and it's just gonna get worse. His kid, I don't know, like probably 100 years from now will be really bad. Yeah, I think it's horrible. I don't think anyone should be alive. Maybe like seeing the world would be cool, or making like really great art, but I think other than that, there's no real point in life.
Oh,
Buddy, where are you? It sounds like a party. I thought you were looking for Dana. Well, I guess what she doesn't know won't hurt her, huh? Oh, man. Last time I was down that way, I got so messed up, I think I killed him. Oh, man. All right, anyway, I'm gonna go.
Huh?
was standing still, so overwhelmed because I was blown up into all the energies. There were demons in certain people's fields. I was shocked, stunned, and scared, and I stared right at this person who had a demon, and he was not facing me, but he turned right around and stared at me like whatever that entity was knew that it was being seen by me, and his whole being shifted. There was this major, powerful collision of energies in that moment.
Oh! Love, it's wonder, it's challenging, it's scary, it's liberating, it's every shade of the rainbow, it's light, it can be dark. Love is totally necessary. I mean, it's the quest, right? Aren't we all looking for love and hungry for love?
You want to try again? To go back to the way it used to be? I remember when we first met, you were gonna conquer the world. You came so close. But then you wasted the chance. What makes you think you won't do the same thing again? I'm not sure. I have to think about it.
For you, me, or anybody. You You just gotta get out.
Thank you.
like shadow and oppression and lies and confusion. If we were given the truth of what it really means to be a sexually embodied individual, and those at the top that are making all this money from feeding us this archetype of control, if people aren't awake in their own sexual essence, they're more easily controlled. There's so many unseen forces. There's the esoteric realms. There's entities that are ETs, that are demons and angels that we invite into our field, whether we're conscious of it or not. so I can see you, yet there could be so much going on within you that I'm not seeing. There's stuff within me that I'm feeling and I'm picking up on, and maybe I can't even consciously speak on what that is.
And I was looking at a hummingbird, and then all of a sudden he flew away, and I stayed over there in this moment that I was not feeling my body. I was not feeling my mind. I could see the colors brighter and I could listen to the sounds higher. When you are so into you, in your own presence, it doesn't matter what is going on around you. You possess yourself, and you can do everything.
I had to kill a snake. I just took a stick and I immobilized her neck, and then another stick in her head. And I cried a lot. I cried a lot. I said, oh my God, I'm sorry. I don't want to kill you. You know, we are part here of the same thing. Because when you are in this limit space, you feel limit, but at the same time, you are so free from everything. So during a certain point of the night, I could listen to the wind, but it was not like a regular wind. It was a really strong presence. And I could feel that it was the force of the wind combining and meeting the force of the water. This spirit of the water, it's called Iemanjá. And the spirit of the wind is called Iansan. So when they meet, you could feel the presence in yourself.
Where does it start? That's where our brain is. That's where our thoughts are processed. What is it? Is it just a room for all of these ideas? Is it a holding space? Is it even truly ours? Are we just floating through here and floating through other places at the same time that we're just not aware of? What we hold on to, what we see the most, is what we've decided to believe. Your consciousness could be anything and nothing all at once. Anything is possible. It's just how much you're open to and willing to believe.
Thank you.
restless in my spells a lot. They're trying to wash everyone out, and I'm sort of fighting back on it. And they're sending phony police, they're sending ill-informed police sergeants that do not have the capacity to understand what a permit is, I suppose. It's in the law. Up with in customs halfway in the middle and buy a new spaceship to undo to hit control Z over and over and over again until you have a stopping point, and then you hit the checkpoint and run backwards and you lateralis out. Limbo to some, limbus to the immortal, and I guess just to everyone else.
A steady faith, but you know, ebbs and flows, but I think perhaps a quieter assurance of right decisions, wrong decisions, or the need to make a change in your life, rather than like the bolt of lightning kind of moment. I think some people naturally inclined, like personality wise, might process and receive information like that, and others don't.
Dana to another hobo, and it turned out it was Willie Brown. And Willie Brown was playing music to my soul on the biz. I had a soul radio, and he was playing to me. He found me in the cosmos. He said one thing to me in Hollywood: vanity will be your downfall. So try not to look at your face too much. Hassled so much by the law. They're trying to wash everyone out, and they're sort of fighting back on it. And they're sending phony police, they're sending ill-informed police sergeants that do not have the capacity to understand what a permit is, I suppose. It's in the law. Thank you.
Thank you. buddy. Is that you? What? Buddy? The hell? I can't be. You look so old. But you're not. Wait. Buddy, I don't know what's going on here. You just gotta find Dana, man. She can figure this out. You should go. I'll go too. Okay?
everything in life happens for a reason, period. Everything has led up to this. This is where I'm evidently supposed to be. In order to be where I am, those mistakes had to be made, or I wouldn't be here and who I am today. And that's what my work is all about. It's all inspirational, uplifting. Some of it's a little negative here and there when I've just had a really pissed off day, and it's just like, fuck you, I don't care who you are, fuck you. You could be the Pope, fuck you, you know?
This superpower of creativity can't take 2 atoms and beat this shit together and create. I can't, if that's the case, keep beating the atoms and keep. I've yet to see great shit. Think about what, how stupid our philosophy is, our wisdom. That everything just fell, boom, 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 in natural order. Oh, a tree is just gonna grow. It makes no goddamn sense. Our so called knowledge that we are stupid.
Thank you.
Are you sure? Have you thought this through? You want to put everything back together, but it doesn't come without the pain. I thought I was over you, but I have to admit, it was great seeing you after so long. Maybe I was wrong about us. I don't know. It's a big decision. Come see me when you've made up your mind.
Humanity is good. People say, oh, you see all the evil. Even the evilest person will have an animal, a dog. I'm talking, we got some evil people who, well, even society, as great as we are, will say they are evil. They did evil things, even as children, whatever. But they might have a dog. Why? Because they can show something love. I think that we are all made of love. But I believe at the core of every human being that exists is love. When I came back, this was all I found. A dead planet with nothing left of you but ashes. So I went away, and I tried to forget you. But then, I thought, maybe I did want to see you again, so I created a place for you to come back to. This place. I'm sorry, I couldn't remember every detail of how it was. It's just been so long. Now it's up to you. You need to decide whether there's a way forward.
whether he lives or he dies. Whether everyone lives or everyone stays dead. I am sorry to put this burden on you.
Ah, you made it. I knew you could. Buddy, I talked to Dana. I hate to tell you this, but she says this is it for you, pal. You're on the wrong side of the mirror. You and this place, you're gonna go away. But as for where I go, that's all up to you. Take my hand, and I get a second chance. All of us get a second chance. That hammer? That's the other choice. But you don't need to use that, because I've changed. I've learned so much from you. That bully in the sewers, you did the right thing. I see that now. And at the theater, you did everything you could, and all the other things you did in the city. I get it. I understand who I need to be. It's your call, buddy. And we're asking you to pull us out. It's what you're here for. Come on, buddy. Take my hand. What are you doing? You're not thinking right. You're throwing it all away. Don't do it, buddy!